Whether you're just beginning your journey toward financial freedom, or you have been investing for years, it remains important to simultaneously save and invest, always keeping an eye out for opportunity and potential pitfalls. Hi there, this is Harry Nima Segarra, founder of Nima Equity, and today we will share some great tips of how to balance saving money and investing at the same time. And honestly, there's always an ongoing challenging balance. So here are my five tips for that. Number one, pay yourself first using a savings account. Have you ever said to yourself, where did that paycheck go? To alleviate the push-pull relationship between earning more versus accumulating higher expenses, you've got to implement pay yourself first anytime you receive some income. Prioritize your savings goal and take it out right away. Take a small percentage of your paycheck, maybe just 5% to start, and place it directly into a savings account. Moving your money to a different account creates an imaginary barrier, protecting you from spending those savings. Rest assured that once you have paid yourself first, you can spend what is in your checking account without feeling guilty. If you're in a position where your job offers direct deposit, you can easily split your deposit by amount or percentage. This allows you to allocate, for example, 5% to your emergency fund and 95% to your checking account. This way, you don't risk forgetting to transfer it or spending it accidentally, and it's automatically done every single time. Number two, let your side hustle fund your investment accounts. Everyone seems to have a side hustle now, right? Where you are trying to reach an income goal or afford a big purchase, a part-time side hustle can really help accelerate your progress. With so many opportunities, both in person and virtually, this is one of the easiest ways to get going in the right direction. The trick here is to take whatever amount you earn from your side hustle and put it toward savings. Number three, create a plan for the unexpected, the emergency savings account. Life always carries risk and unexpected twists and turns. You may not plan for a specific amount of money, but you can always save a general amount or a percentage of money to create a little safety net. You never know when unplanned expenses like a car repair, job transition, or some type of financial hardship might pop up. As you build your emergency fund, you can adjust the amount saved based on your expenses and obligations, and reevaluate your savings account's goals once or twice a year. Financial experts agree you should aim to save 3 to 6 months of expenses in your emergency fund. Maintaining a hefty emergency fund is a great way to keep your retirement funds, investment accounts, and other savings accounts intact. Number four, pay off your loans aggressively. I'm guessing you may be stir upset or disappointed at your phone or computer whenever you see the total balance on your loans and credit cards. You're not alone. There's always a tremendous benefit to working with financial advisors who can review your credit report, compare it to your personal financial budget, and help create a debt payoff plan. They will know how to consider interest rates, minimum payment requirements, and work with you to prioritize which debts should be paid off first. Simply put, even if your income doesn't increase, by deleting your high interest debt, you will free up more money for your investing and saving account goals. Number five, learn about your investments. Stock market, funds, REITs, real estate deals, etc. Every CD, broker service transaction, securities deal, and mutual fund has a cost. So as you walk your financial journey toward building wealth by saving and investing simultaneously, you'll want to pay special attention to the fees required by each opportunity. If you're looking at the mutual funds inside your retirement or brokerage accounts, for example, it is a great idea to look at how much they cost compared to the projected returns. The more you know about fee and transaction information, the better, more profitable financial decisions you can make for yourself. So, ready to master your savings versus investment ratio? No matter where you are along the path toward financial freedom, the key takeaways here are to take the time to set up and review your financial goals. Having a periodic money day to allow rebalancing, evaluate your risk tolerance, adjust your budget, explore new financial products, or change your wealth management strategy is key. Last but not least, help others find this video by giving it a thumbs up. Want to hear more about finance, real estate, and syndications? Please make sure you subscribe so you will know when I post a new video. With a friend or a colleague who might find this interesting, share this video with them too. I'm Harry Nima Segarra with Nima Equity. I'll see you again soon.